Okay, the game is just about to begin here at the park in Corriveau, and there's the whistle to set them alight with the two teams, Nandi against Northland, and it's Northland playing from our left, the equivalent of the what would be the town end of Suva's TFL, and obviously the Nandi team playing in the opposite direction. And for those who later on are going to be lucky enough to have a look at the television, you'll see Northland in the yellow come orange jerseys, and it'll be Nandi in the blue. And there immediately Nandi goes straight on to the attack, down to the grandstand side of the field, if you could call it grandstand sideline, and immediately brought back into play just inside the 22 metre line of Northland territory. Quickly running through the teams then that are playing. Northland, the front row of Chris Kawata, Akariva Tinidhiwa, and Bulamai Vali are the props. The locks, Benedito Rockambolini and Tamani Maiasia. The flankers, Saki Mbose and Semi Solaki. The number 8 is Ponajesi Tundral. The half is Semi Vortia. The playmaker is Valavatu Rambuku. Isor Tute is in inside centre, outside centre, Petero Nondrakoro. The left wing is Apeti Tamani. The right wing is Risi Ngilai and John Bola at full back. For Nandi, he's on Damundamu, that's a famous name, isn't it? Sekeli Ngavindi are the props to Napoleon Ndawai. The locks, Serevi, Seri Kalevu, and Vili Ratute. The flankers, Simi Kunatani and Senatiki the Cow, again a good name, and Manoa Ngoro at number 8. The halfback is Jack Luita. The playmaker is Kalamendi Vosunga. The inside centre is Sinivalati Ngonovo. The outside centre, Samu Ndava. Vili Raikivi on the right wing. The left wing is Sekeli Lingani the Koro. And the fullback is Iliasa Samu Samu Vondre. And a feature of the two games this afternoon, I felt, was the expertise of the two fine coaches that are respectively coaching the sides. For Northland, the coach is Ili, of course, Ili Tambua, a man with a long reputation, and an equally long reputation for Nandi is, of course, Iliasur. And then I forget him, yet I was just talking to him a few minutes ago, and we were all anxious about the quality of the ground, the circumstances prevailing today. And although, as this game has just begun, we see that the conditions have stopped, the rain has stopped here, and on the basis of the rain stopping, we'll at least be able to see them a little better. But those who are lucky enough to watch the television later tonight will be able to see the treacherous, the dreadful conditions that prevail here at this park here in Corriveau. So nothing much has moved from the 22 metre line where I last had a look at the game before I gave you the players in that side, and now we're right on the 22 metre line, 3 minutes into the game, and in that position a scrum going down, and in it's gone from Luita, and they all tumbled to the ground, and just before they fell to the ground the referee decided penalty to Nandi could be a first scoring opportunity for Nandi with the rain just started again. Just a light drizzle, but it's enough to keep the ground extremely wet, and at the same time footholds just appalling. So with a minuscule crowd that is here, many with umbrellas, many not, and the absolute conditions are conditions that would only be played, I think, in Fiji. With conditions as they are, I see that the park is much the same as what it was a couple of years ago when we were here for Northland's match, one of those that were on the Digicel program of 2 years ago, and conditions exactly the same, a very wet track, and conditions above a trifle better than they are today. So here we've got Vosunga lining it up to see if he can get the first points on the board for Nandi, which has only had one win so far in the competition, the Digicel Cup competition we're playing, of course, and Northland there with two wins, and Northland leading the Digicel table. So just waiting for Vusunga. Let's watch him as he's a right footer moving. It's a metre outside the 22. He's hooked it away. Oh, but the flags are up, so he couldn't have hooked it too far. But the flight of the ball was outside the right-hand upright. And at this stage, it's Nandi on the board first. A penalty in the third, running on to the fourth minute. A penalty. Vusunga, the right footer, the playmaker for Nandi. It was successful, and he has converted the penalty into points. 3 points to nil as they come back to the halfway line, and so too does the rain come back to greet us. So ready to go, it is Rumbuku for Northland, ready to set it in motion. Almost looks like Kirtley Beale, the way in which he handled that ball there, and got a ball up there, which I thought was knocked forward by Nandi. Ball on the ground, and out it comes. The advantages to Northland. A kick across towards the grandstand sideline, and a sliding take. As they went into the ground, looked like Ritsute who'd taken it. On the ground he was, and Nandi follow it through. They've managed to get the ball back on their side, and waiting for it, Luita, and stretch it straight back behind him, and this becoming a kicking game already. The ball skids inside the 22-metre line in Northland Territory, only to be returned, and back it comes, and a little bit of soccer is the attempt, as back it came, and Ratute again moved it across to the right, across to Vusunga. Vusunga to Luita. Luita in a dodging run. He manages to hold his feet comfortable as Dava goes down this grandstand sideline, gets a bit of green grass under his feet, goes down to the ground, and back it comes across the right flank. The cow gets it across to Siri Kalevu. He's taken down to the ground on the 10-meter line in Northland Territory, and with the Nandi forwards showing no signs of grief in a game like this today, it strikes it forward there, Northland taking them down. It's Nandi again, another effort there. Luita takes it into centre field. The defence strong as out it goes again, across this time to Vusunga. Vusunga across onto the right flank. In this time, Somerset Wanderer into the back line. He takes it up. He took it up almost to the 22-metre line again. But frankly, they've just gone across the field. It was a matter of pick, try to go forward, driven back, try to go forward. And it's a series of just that as the penalty is awarded against Nandi. Held ball on the ground. And we have a situation where the penalty is awarded 10 outside the 22-metre line in Northland Territory, close to a tightly packed, covered area across the far side, and the crowd rather hushed as they see Northland equaled in this opening sector by a strong and powerful Nandi side who look as if they're well versed in the conditions underfoot. Forward they come, and out from the far side it was, and that was Billy Raikivi logged it into touch. It was in touch on the full from outside the 22-metre line, and we have it there. A line-out will take place. This will be a put-in by Northland, and this now will just about be the closest that Northland have been to the Nandi try-liners. In it comes. Knocked, I thought it was knocked through that time by the big man, Maiasia, but the referee, yes, he did, he said so, but he also spotted something in the line-out, but the rain doesn't let us see it. As in it goes, up over over the 10-metre line it is. They've got a flag on it, unusually, as down it goes beyond the 10-metre line, and now Northland bullying their way forward, almost up to the 22 in Nandi territory, and the rain hustling them along there, the ball on the ground there in Northland's side, a drive and a lost ball forward as he was bumped in a tackle, but the referee has said it was offside Nandi, offside outside the 22-metre line, and here's a retaliatory opportunity for Northland to have a shot at goal. This they're going to do from a position four outside the 22, and in that position, it would be about the same distance away as Vusunga managed to get the opening points for Nandi 3 or 4 minutes ago. No, he's taken it back into a decent foothold, at least a decent piece of grass from which to kick, and that will be just 10 outside the 22-metre line, and we'll see just what he manages to do from here. A left footer, it looks like it's Rumbuku to take it. Rumbuku, rather than Rumbuku. No, it's fullback. It's the fullback, John Boller, the left footer, John Boller, and he's looking over his right shoulder as he aims to get it forward. He does get it forward, but it's not accurate enough nor far enough. Taken back there by Zamazama Vondre. A big high kick as he slid to the ground, and the ball almost in touch. Didn't quite make it over the halfway line, down towards the 10-metre line it went. And in touch, it really was just 2 or 3 metres in the northland part of territory. So that Nandi were let off the hook that time, and as they're let off, the line-out will take place, and this will be a Northland put-in. A quick tap and drive, and they take it up over the halfway line. Northland lose the ball. It's a turnover, and going through there. Gone. No luck that time, though, as it rebounded, and it's a turnover. Out it comes to the grandstand sideline in Gillay. Gillay comes up towards the grid, towards the halfway line, and there he's taken down, buried in the green, the bit of green that's there, and out it goes out onto the open. An effort to go through onto Myasir again. He's taken it forward towards the 10-metre line, and back it comes towards the grandstand side of the field. A dummy pass, and eventually it comes across to Gillay. Gillay again, and Gillay goes down to the grandstand sideline, and I can't see a thing. I can't see a thing with all those people there, whether it was a try or whether it wasn't. There are too many umbrellas as we could see on the screen, and I guess it must be the local crowd jumping for joy as it appeared that the ball infield from Roccambolini, and the try in there. Eventually Gillay gets the opening try, and that was a fine piece of work considering the ground conditions, and the ground conditions were very difficult, not only for those the ball carrier, but the defenders trying to get across fast enough to cut him off. But Gillay was able to score right in the corner, as we saw Roccambolini, as I said, was right behind him, and he was sent into touch. So a good piece of work, and the opening try by Ngilai for Nandi, for Northland rather, has taken Northland in front, and that takes them to 5-3, a kick to come, and that would be in the 12th minute of the game. We wait as the ball... It's a good-looking kick too, but it drifts away outside the left-hand upright. Not quite far enough either, but the try was the important part of it, giving
Northland a lead after now 13 minutes of play. Northland in front by 5 points to 3. Well, the home crowd certainly rejoiced with that one. It was a fine effort from Mengele as he gathered right on the halfway line and then headed off. He avoided the first tackle over the 10-metre line and then had a clear run to inside the 22. And that's where all these umbrellas obscured our view. Couldn't quite see too much of it. And I asked those people if they would move back to give us a chance to be able to tell Fiji, the whole of Fiji, not just the people of Corriveau, what's happening to the ground here. As well, there's the kickoff, a long one from Northland. They return the favour, send it back. Outside the 10-metre line it goes, picked up off the ground. Good piece of work, high into the air again from Nandi, and the follow-up in there from Manasangoro. He takes it up, Northland recover it. They send it forward, stops in a puddle, and back it goes again. Samuvondre takes it up over the 10-metre line in Northland territory. Centre field, it's gone. Ball on the ground, out it comes again, out to Manasangoro. He gives it across to Damundamu, not the one we know from the sevens, but another one, as a mistake by Northland and an overkick by Nandi. Drive it into the corner, over it's gone, and that was sent forward by the Nandi team, and that becomes a dropout 22 with Nandi overkicking that ball that was not taken cleanly on defence by Northland. We've got instead the dropout with a score at 5 points to 3, Northland leading after 15 minutes of play. The early points in the fourth minute, of Vasonga, a penalty in favour of Nandi, the visitors, and it was a try just moments ago. And there's the dropout from that overkick into the dead ball line and taken in there by Ndamundamu for Nandi. He's collared and taken down, buried in amongst the muddied water. And they're lined out Northland. Nandi get it. They're ready to drive, and it is a drive across all towards the short side of the field as they move it forward there. Coming out, getting it, the cow ready to pick and drive. Gets it, gets the support of Nandi right in there with him. They drive forward there, close to the touchline on that terrace sideline. Small crowd across there, really jam-packed and into the shelter. As we see, back out it comes again. That's time to Luita. Luita takes it, and underneath, I think, was he given it there as it went over the 22-metre line? I'm sure he thought that was a try. I'm sure he thought that was where the goal line was, but in fact, it was only the 22-metre line, and from the lost ball forward by Nandi, it is a scrum to go down. Six outside the 22-metre line, and it will be a Northland put-in. Northland's halfback Vortea poised to put it in. And in it goes, and there's no foothold. They managed to swivel the scrum and taken off there. Kunatani goes forward. Kunatani then lost the ball, and back out it comes from halfback Luita again. Out it comes, and Nandi driving forward. That's the 22-metre line that you could see right there, as out it comes again. Dewai gets it. He goes forward up towards that 22-metre line, and back it comes. The halfback there is Luita. He's looking for the ball again. Out it comes. Nicely taken an infield. A reverse pass on Onovo. He takes it up over the halfway line. He's got it in a hand on it. They've got it again. It's picked up again by Luita. Luita then does a dummy. He manages to go on his own. He's isolated. Can he get there? He dives early, leaves the ball behind, and it was scrambled up in there, and Nandi have retaliated with a try, and Nandi's try neatly done after the ball was lost to the ground. It was dropped behind from Ngonavo, and then it was Ratute who was right there to help. Ratute gets the try, and that takes Nandi back into the lead. After they had the opening lead with a penalty, it was Northland that came back, and now it's Nandi again with that going on to 8 points to 5. And because it's a try scored very handy, there is a chance that this one could be converted. And it's Ratute who got that one. Ratute, who's been busy right in the middle of it all in the opening 15 minutes of play. Ratute has handled it probably more than anybody else. The big lock, a man of experience, working for Nandi, playing for Nandi for years gone by, and he certainly justified his selection with a try like that. We look now for Vasunga to see whether he can convert from just to the right of the post. The flags go up, and yes it is. It's 8 points to five. Going on to 10 points to five, the converted try, and Vasunga, who had managed the early penalty, has managed also a conversion. And so again, we're glad we can see the ground easily now as the rain has again stopped. It seems to be on again and off again, just like the two teams are from one end of the field to the other as we wait for Rumbuku to restart. Restarting in the center field, he's got many a puddle to avoid as he takes it back into just a higher pitch of ground to see if he can kick it off from the green patch. He doesn't do it very successfully. Doesn't go 10 metres. Picked up in there by the cow. The cow takes it forward for Nandi. 5 metres inside the 10-metre line for Northland. And back it comes. Half-backing Luita gets it across towards the grandstand sideline. And doesn't get terribly far as they come again. Nandi recovering. The cow with it again. Goes over the halfway line. They've got still inside Northland territory. Longer pass this time. Vasunga links up out on the outside. Sama Vundri into the back line. Across onto the right wing. And across there, we've got Raikivi. Raikivi is taken down and has a swim across the touchline just on the 10-metre line in Northland territory. So it will be a put-in with Northland to put it in with the ball going out off the Nandi fingertips, but Nandi trying to play dry weather rugby here. They're almost exceeding. They seem very adept at being able to handle that ball and have certainly deserved to be in front. They've made so much more of the play, and despite the fact that today they're the underdog, they're certainly doing themselves proud. Waiting for it into the line out up high, right down towards the back. It was knocked through by Northland. Referee says advantage to Nandi. It's on the 10-metre line in Northland territory, and they're coming through as Tundrau. Tundrau, I believe, might have been penalised for coming through offside, trying to gather that ball. Yes, it is. There's the penalty I expected. And quickly coming through again with it is Kunatani. Kunatani puts it down at the toe of the referee and waits for his own fellows to pick themselves up out of all the muddy puddles, ready to prepare for the kick into touch, or towards touch, by Vasunga. Vasunga looking across towards the short side, and he makes sure of it. Not a greedy kick, and it's a good one that's taken it into touch, almost on the 22-metre line in Northland territory, with Nandi gaining good ground, and of course retaining position by virtue of it being a penalty into touch. Wait now for the line out. In it comes, and again, way down the back for the centre. It's a lost ball. Tundrau taking it to the back of the line out for Northland. Scrambled up there and getting it is Vautier. Vautier then sends a deep one, goes back to Rumbuku. He puts a high one into the air and taking it fine in good condition across towards the grandstand sideline, running backwards, neatly taken in there by Ngonavo. Ngonavo across to the grandstand sideline and here into touch. Should I call it the broadcast sideline? I think we're on a bit of a platform over here, and in that position we're trying to see through the crowd. And with the ball into touch on the 22-metre line, it will be put in from Northland. The ball not really carrying unless it's a low kick and it'll skid its way. But when it goes into the air, you'll notice carefully just how it stops, where it bounces. And the tendency is for those who are following up to overrun the ball. And one must be very careful in these conditions. Then it goes from Northland, flicked back by Nandi, a turnover again. It's taken back in there by Kunitani. He's roving well as a flanker. He's managed to stop it from going forward, and it's picked up back in there by Manasa Ngoro. Comes down the grandstand sideline in the hands of Ratute again. It's gone to ground, a lost ball forward. And not surprising that the ball went into touch. The referees let it be in touch and said, we'll take a line-out rather than a scrum, and let the line-out be 2 metres outside, 2 metres, yes, distant from the 22-metre line on our broadcast side of the field. Remind you that this is one of the Digicel Cup competitions, and this between the leaders, Northland, and one of the lowly ranked teams, Nandi. Nandi doing the better of the two, being able to cope with these heavy conditions on this park here. As out it comes, and no sign of it being picked up. It's gathered there again. Neatly done by Luita, who's controlling the ball well. A pick and drive, and again, Luita again gets it across to the cow. The cow reveling in the conditions as well as he goes forward. He's caught 20 out from the goal line. Ball onto the ground, straight in front of the post it is, but distant from by 20. They've been pushed back by Northland for the moment. Back they go, and another effort. Big effort in there. The big man, Sikilingavini, he took it forward there, but lost ground again as Northland turned them back in the splashing, muddied area just in front of the 22-metre line. Ball on the ground again. The effort is on. A lot of oomph going into this. A lot of grunt to get the ball. Nandi pick it up. The referee has said, hang on, fellas. It was lost ball forward, and he said, we'll take the scrum. Now, scrum will go down just inside the 22-metre line, and 5 metres in, and it would be midway corner flag and upright in that position, with it is Nandi leading Northland by 10 points to 5. Converted try and a penalty. Play gone in this first half now, just on 25 minutes. Scrum to go down. And it will be in from Vortea, and Nandi driving them back and offside on this grandstand side of the field. He was a mile in front. Senatiki the cow, the referee looked over the top of the scrum and caught him cheating. And there's the penalty against, and going back off. So is Damu Damu, but he wasn't offside. It was the cow who was on the open side. Now the penalty to Rumbuku. He'll take it with his left foot, kicking towards the packed, covered area across on that side of the field. And no, he gave it across. He gave it to somebody else that time. Rumbuku is the left footer. He gave it outside. And I do believe that was Tute who took it and drove it into touch and landed on the roof with a resounding wallop, signaling a return of the rain once again. Ball in touch, almost on the halfway line, and it will be a Northland throw-in. As we look to see it coming way down the back, right over the top, it's gone loose, and here gets getting it first. There's that quick-footed halfback Luita. He went to lay on the ball, but it escaped his grip. It's gone back then, was kicked through, taken on by Samusova Madre. Cross onto the right flank. He goes wide to go forward, almost over the touchline, and taken down to the ground. They scramble for it in another puddle. On the ground it is, and Luita directing his traffic, and with somebody knocking the ball out of the hand, a ball gone to the ground, is taken up there by Northland. They take it forward after the penalty, reaching inside Nandi territory. Again it comes, and from across this grandstand side of the field, this is another effort to get inside Nandi's territory. Better picked up that time, and they take it infield, not playing taking any chances with it. Nandi, as they moved it infield to the VAR, he drove it into touch, and a bouncing ball got there before the attackers. The Northland team got across to cover it, and the ball then going into touch for a Northland throw almost on the 22-metre line. Again, 28 minutes gone. It's 10 points to 5. Nandi leading Northland here in these dreadful conditions on the park here at Corriveau. Rain still with us as we're waiting now for the line-out to take place. And these jolly umbrellas blocking our view as we're waiting for the ball to go in. And once again, there is a stoppage. And this is really the first stoppage for anybody to have had an injury. And I guess if it's not an injury, it would be a bit of mud in somebody's eye. They'll be getting some help there. And that then has held up play for a moment. And it gives the Northland side a chance to have a chat at their ploy. And I can see coming across from the far side of the field, the Tinidhiwa is the hooker of Northland. He had mud in his eye, and he's had that cleared and is now joining his lot in the line-out on our broadcast side of the field. He goes in, and he's not himself throwing it in. It is Bulimaivale is taking it in, and Bulimaivale will do the throwing. In it goes, and oh, and a wonderful take in there, brilliantly done by Northland as they pushed Nandi away, but the referee said no, it wasn't straight, despite the good work in there by Solaki for the Northland side, and to their disappointment, Northland faced the scrum with a put in from Nandi. Just a metre inside the 22-metre line in the Nandi end of the ground, and it will be the hard-working Luita at halfback for Nandi to put it in. He's certainly distinguished himself as a wet-weather rugby player, the way in which he's been able to handle the ball and direct the traffic as well. He's got control of his outside backs, and certainly it's led to something worthwhile. The penalty, it was underneath his own hooker's foot, and it is a short-arm penalty quickly taken in there. There's Votia. He's playing against Luita and takes the play up. 10 up from the goal line, 15 in from the grandstand side of the field. It's Northland with an opportunity. Joining them in there is Gillay, the scorer of Northland's only try in the early stages of the game. But then Nani get it away, and a big ball goes right back inside Northland's territory, gathered there by Mbola. And Bola kicks towards touch without success. Taken instead by Ndamu Ndamu. He goes up, bulldozes his way forward, almost up to the 10-metre line. On the ground it is. Nandi looking for it. It's coming through their ruck and reaching in for it. Liuta again. Liuta gets it back again. Vosunga. Vosunga sends it further back. Bounces over the 22-metre line, stops in a puddle inside it. And picked up by fullback Bola. Oh, a dangerous kick. It's taken by Nandi. They set up the counter-attack. Here goes Vosunga. Goes across to the right flank. A testing ball. It went up through Samusamavondre. Across onto the right wing. Raikivi tries to dodge his way infield. It would be better to go outside. He ran into the oncoming defence. And here, a penalty awarded to Nandi. And in a hard tackle, as we had Lavindi going down that sideline, the ball popped out as a bubble out of a champagne bottle, and into touch it went, and it will be a lost ball forward from that hard tackle, and we'll have the scrum to go down almost on the 22-metre line across the, we'd call it the terrace side of the field. Well, the crowd, I think, has grown somewhat from the early stages on, with now the game gone on 32 minutes, and it will be halfback Vortea to put it in for Northland. In it goes, and again the scrum screwed around by Nandi, but Northland managed to clear it away. A high ball that's come out from Ramuku, gets a long one, straight into the waiting hands of Samusamavondre. Across coming from the wing was Lingani Koro. He's caught though and taken down to the ground. And as he's caught on the ground, out onto the right flank it goes. This time it's caught by Rakivi on the other side of the field. He sends it backwards. Good piece of work on to Serikalevu. Serikalevu decides he wants to be in the kicking game. Drives it forward up to the 22. Might have been a forward pass that time, but I don't think you'd worry too much about it in the conditions. A bouncing ball picked up neatly in there by playmaker Vosunga. A flick from behind picked up by Nandi, but they run right into the face of the oncoming Northlanders and the ball on the ground. And there was a little bit after action in there by Solaki, and the referee calling a halt to play for a moment as the players want to carry on with their disagreements. And the referee in full control. The players don't want to know about control, and there's still a few smiles on some of the faces of those who weren't involved. And I think you'd think nothing more nor less would be an apt response to somebody getting a little upset. But there's the word, and the word was that to Solaki, who needlessly gave a Nundy player a flick, and Solaki is the subject of conversation, you can be sure, between the referee and one of his assistants on this near grandstand sideline. Now is the referee calling in the... Yes, he's calling in Solaki, and so too the... Or is Solaki the captain? And the player is being cautioned out there, and not only cautioned, but he's got a yellow card, and this will see one man taking a rest for the 10-minute period, and that looks now, with the injury on the grandstand sideline, it looks as if it will be Tinidhiwa who will have the yellow card. Meantime, on the ground here, it is Solaki who gets the card. It's the right way around, and the injury was to Ngile, who's on his feet, indicates he's okay, and here is the penalty awarded, 8 metres inside Nandi's territory, a chance for them to take ground as half-time is looming about 5 minutes away. So back it goes, the ball in touch, just on the 10-metre line in, it will be Northern Territory. Sides are slowing down a little bit now. I think the heavy underfoot conditions have taken a lot of energy out of the 30 minutes of play that there has been. As up high Nandi went, the ball lost to the ground. And while it was knocked through by Sirikalevu, a referee has said, hang on there. And he awards a penalty to Northland with somebody actually playing it in front of Sirikalevu. And that would have been, I think, the halfback Luita. As I can't quite see him, his number, but I can pick him. Now it was Vasunga. Vasunga was the man who went through offside, and there's the penalty to Northland inside their own half, and the kick is towards our broadcast sideline. High ball, doesn't find touch, my ball, you tickets it. And back it comes to his own fullback, and from there, Samasama Vondre, he didn't find it either. Picked up by Tinidhiwa. Tinidhiwa took it over the 10-metre line, caught and held. He's taken down onto the ground, and here it's Northern ball. They get it. They recycle it. Send a long one through Mbosse. Had a chip kick forward there. Scrambled up there. Did, yes, it got away. Well done, Thawa. And Thama gets it on to Linganinkoro. Puts a huge kick down. And the ball gone into touch a long way down, but it's out into touch on the full from just outside the 22-metre line. And lo and behold, the line umpire brings it back to inside the 22-metre line, which might have meant that it was legal rather than a kick that was outside the 22. Well, just a little bit of a consequence there, but nobody complaining, nobody pointing it out, but here is the throw-in from Northland, from a metre inside Nandi's territory. A big tap back, but well taken in there by Voltaire. Gets it a long pass out, gone on to Mbosse. Mbosse takes it forward. He goes down to the ground, slipped it more than anything else, and with the ball on the ground, and Nandi going in over the top. The penalty is against, and I think, although it's inside the half, five inside, I think it might be too long for anybody to take a shot at goal. So Rumbuku is looking at the terrace touchline, and he looks as if he's looking to clear it into touch, taking Northland forward, seeking a try before the halftime break as the ball soared into touch. It's 10 outside the 22-metre line on that far side of the field. again. Somebody else getting some assistance across there with some muddied eyes, and now he's clear. And again, Mbosse, who has been featuring strongly more in the backs than the forwards, even if he is a flanker. And Mbosse was the one who had his eyes cleaned. As into the line-out it goes, it was a very untidy line-out, but out it comes, Bossy again. He's got it in the midfield. He goes forward, shoulder into the opposition as they come at him. Down onto the ground, five outside the 22, centre field it is. Looking for it and getting it to would appear to be Northland. They've got it, Vautier drives it out, Bossy. A fling out and the ball bounces off the Northland side. Nandi take it, they bring it up to their own 10-metre line, picked it up again, gone back that time to the cow. The cow then flicks it across the grandstand sideline, gives it on to Raikivi. Raikivi tries to bump his way in there, and that might have been considered to be a dangerous tackle as they tried to go forward quickly. Nandi called back and said, let's take it closer to the touchline, and they take it in the green patch, just 5 metres inside Nandi territory. Are we waiting now? This will be Vasonga again. Played a good part of the game in the first half and combined well with Luita. And there, does he get it? Yes, he got it into touch. And I would have said he knocked it forward back in there. And the referee, yes, he did too, and said, we'll take the scrum from the knock forward rather than from anything else. And the Northland fullback thought that he had knocked it backwards. That's why he was in doubt when the whistle went. And we have a scrum to go down, and Nandi back onto the attack again. 40 minutes gone. We're in extra time of the first half with Nandi leading Northland by 10 points to 5. Luita to put it in again for Nandi. 10 out from the goal line. In it goes. Luita gets it. Clears it out to Vosunga. Vosunga, a dummy pass and out wide. It's gone on to Rakivi's in the back line. And the ball then lost the ground. Picked up across on the far side. Gilai on the far wing this time. He went across to cover and was able to close the gap as Rakivi also had come from this grandstand sideline across to the far side. And with the ball popping up, it became nobody's ball, the ball to ground, a scrum formed, and it would favour, I would presume, the attacking side. Whose ball is it to put it in? Northland? It is, it's in the hands of Vautier to put in. Just five inside the 22-metre line, and they screw the scrum even before it. The ball is in, and nobody's ball again. Vautier tried to pick it up, left it behind. It was Nandi went to take it and then managed to fall forward offside. And with the ball left behind them, it is a chance for Northland to clear as the rain comes to us again. This will be a chance for Northland to get away from their own goal line with time up in the first half. We're in referee's time now, and there were several stoppages, you remember, for the first half cleaning of the eyes, and the referee pointing to the center now. So it's half time in this digital contest between Northland and Nandi. The visitors from Nandi opening the scoring in the fourth minute with a fairly simple penalty from Vasonga, and that made it 3 points to nil in 8 minutes time. From then, it was a lovely try down the grandstand sideline, and that try was scored by Gilai, and Gilai then gave Northland a handy lead. The conversion failed, very difficult in the conditions, and that Northland's lead was 5 points to 3. Then in the 24th minute, it was a good effort, a grand effort there, where again the ball was left behind. It was difficult to pick up in the other end of the ground, and Nandi, with a good backup, Ratute was right there, and Ratute was able to gather, score handy to the post for an easy conversion by Vasonga, and that made up the scoring in the first half of this Digicel Cup contest between Northland at home to Nandi, and the game played in treacherous conditions. And as I said earlier on, when I think of the main features of this game, is the clash of the coaching efforts by two strong and very experienced coaches. It's Ili Tambua for Northland, and we've got the former Sevens coach coaching for Nandi, and I could see the influence of the Nandi coach's efforts with so much kicking that's going on. He initiated it, Northland have followed suit, but Nandi seem to have had the better of the first half, much more possession. They haven't been able to finish off several of their drives forward. Otherwise, we may have seen a higher score at this halftime break, with Nandi leading Northland by 10 points to 5. Handball it back by Nandi has cost them dearly. Another loss of territory as there's another penalty awarded to Northland. And coming up is Joan Bowler. Is he going to take it, or is he leaving it for Rockatheri? A shot at goal. This might be a little optimistic from 15 outside the 22 and about 8 metres in from the terrace side of the field. A shot, and who is going to take it? Let you think, who is it that's across there? The new man that's on, this I think is Rockatheri. And we have on, yes, Ratambavada is on. We're just waiting for the kick as it's stepped back. No, it's the fullback Joan Bowler who is actually taking the shot at goal. And he steps a long way back and it comes in from the side. Oh, and it was a long way short, a heavy ball, and not a good footing, and it was picked up by Nandi. They thread their way through the defence that's wide and thin, and taking it over the 22, 12 metres outside the 22. This time the penalty is against Northland for handball on the ground, and across it comes, and Wanavo gives it across onto the right flank, across to Thavar, takes it up to the half, down onto the ground. Again, it's Nandi looking for it. They're coming the short side. They've got numbers there. Reverse pass, neatly done, onto Ratumai. Ratumai inside the Northland territory goes down. It's set up for halfback Aaron Avanua. Has taken it forward, given it wide. No way through there. The Northland defence has tightened up. Another drive through there. Naki Thambola. And he's gone forward. Ball on the ground and out it comes again. Aaron Avanua, get it away, again, flicks a longer pass, the miss-out pass it was earlier, and back into line comes Monavo. He straightened it up, went forward, made good ground inside the Northland Territory, across wide it was Ratumai, and they bring it back towards the grandstand side of the field, trying to link up with some laggards across on this grandstand sideline, but no way through. Stopped in the process by Northland. A chip over the top then from Votia. Sends it down. Not the same mistake from fullback this time. And instead it's Matiaki. He got ball in hand. Taking it up over the 22. Corton taken down. The penalty against Nandi. And we have Matiaki playing in there. And he's at fullback instead of Samusamavondre. That was a handball on the ground again. Nandi trying to desperately to get it back, no way through, and it looks as if we have an arm injury on the ground, and the man who's been running well for Nandi, Linganikolo, is getting some attention at the breakdown, and it seems to me he may have problems with the shoulder. So they went to the break with Nandi leading by 10 points to 5 against the home side Northland. And in the fourth minute of the second half, we had a penalty to Northland, which brought them closer together, 10 points to 8. And at 10 points to 8, they went on to the 25th minute, and there was that brilliant try by Ngiliai, who used the treacherous conditions to his advantage, picked up a ball off the ground that it looked as if it was carrying on through. He picked it up and in a couple of paces dived over, was able to take the lead. 15 points to 10, and now Northland with a chance to add to that tally And it will be a matter of, can Jim Bowler succeed with this? And indeed he does. He succeeds and makes it 18 points to 10, with Bowler getting his second penalty, and to that the two conversions of the two tries, leading putting the home side in front in a comfortable position after 35 minutes of the second half. Well, that's surprising that they were able to lift the ball high as they did to make it workable, and there from the kickoff was the same sort of thing that went before. Northland come forward to take it. They all drive in there. Nandi standing flat, not enough depth in their attempt to cut Northland off, and Northland working their way through, driving forward. They got numbers there in total, but then the referee said that one of them came in from the side. Penalty against, and here's Nandi again. Here's that busy man, the cow, going forward over the 22, over the 10-meter line, down towards the 22. He went caught and taken to the ground, but back out it comes to Nandi. A drive through there, Lumulima taking it forward again. The ball lost forward, picked up by Northland. The home side, knowing the conditions, I think you'd almost say, went backwards, and the ball kicked towards touch across on the far side. They're picked up by Rakivi, who cleverly anticipated the ball going forward. He was able to take it, and back it came again. And there's another one, Wanganui Tai. He takes it forward, and wasn't able to get the ball, and Northland have gone in again by fast following. In it has come, and Tini Thiwa was right on the ball to be able to score, and that was, again, the ground, the conditions, the water upon it, was playing tricks with the defence. There wasn't enough depth in the defence, and in came the hooker Tini Thiwa and dived a distance on it and had a great ride almost to the dead ball line on the ball itself. So it is Northland have gone on further ahead, 23 points to 10. Nandi have failed to capitalize on their early opportunities, and with the strengthening, the tightening up of the forwards in the second half, there's no doubt about it, they worked together, they worked with a lot more support than they'd given in the first half, and it's paid off with Tamani. It is now on, or is Tamani is off, but let's see this conversion effort again from Bowler with his left footer. It looks good, and the flags are up. It's 25 points to 10. And Farasiko is on for Tamani. Farasiko is in, and Tamani is off for the Northland side. And we have now gone 38 minutes, and I think you could rightly say that Northland have worked their way into a lead that won't be reversed in the remaining time of the game. Long kick, low, but soccer was the game out there for Matiaki. Picked it up, and he sent it back with interest to take the ball inside the 22-meter line. Picked up it back in here by Nandi. Little chip kick over the top, over the heads of some of the Northland players advancing. And again, the same sort of trick, but Northland go to the ground with it and picked up again. Taken forward there by Wanganui Tai. A rebound. Back it comes inside the 22. Northland trying to add to their tally at the moment. They kept the ball in play with a kick right down the touchline into the centre field. And there, Nandi, unable to drive forward. Picked up neatly in there. It was taken by Solaki. Solaki took it up to the 22-meter line. And he had the support when it stopped. When he stopped, and out it come. It's come on from onto Rockatheri. Wide out it's gone. And ball lost to the ground, but it was picked up across on the far side. Gillet again. He got a ball in hand, trying to work his way forward, but he's caught up by the defence coming up after him. Picked up in there, Tundrau. He goes over the short side. He's attempting to go forward, driven towards touch, and the referee has said, man offside. Play gets underway again with a quick and a short one. That Northland, not back 10 metres, get a penalty against. got minutes running away. We're just on full time now with the Northland in front by 25 points to 10. And the referee holding up play while somebody gets their face washed again and says there was a penalty to Nandi. Penalty to Nandi, and that is on Nandi's 10-meter line while he's busy, the referee busy talking. It's a yellow card to Northland, and it is Northland off there. It is Rotute. Rotute is off. He certainly gave a powerful first half and just became involved at the latter stages as Nandi go forward again. Big effort in there from Ngoro, who must have come back onto the field again, is over the 10-meter, over the halfway line, it's gone, up to the 10-meter, and here's Nandi still going forward. They're up to the 10 now. Again it comes, grandstand side of the field, ball on the ground. They've made it into the depths with the cow, giving big and powerful efforts again for Nandi, been probably the player of the afternoon for Nandi in the forwards. Ball on the ground, close to the 22-meter line. Nandi going forward again. Erina Vanua takes it forward. He's caught. Gives it infield again to the cow. He's in everything, as I said before. Ball on the ground. Here he goes again. This time coming out. Erina Vanua. Out it comes onto the open. It's come across to Nico Thambula. And he's got the ball inside the 22-meter line. 15 out from the goal line. 5 in from the grandstand sideline. Nandi again. But the defense holding, but no, he was able to get through. And will he get the ball down? I can't see because there's a man in the way. And no, the referee has said, he's pointing to the center of the field, and there is game over. There's no try in that one. It was stopped, it was held up, and instead of a try, the game, the referee turned around, pointed into the centre, and the Northlanders are celebrating a victory. They will hold their place at the top of the Digicel Cup table with Nandi having to be content with their one victory in their opening game of the tournament. So, with conditions totally against playing good open rugby, there's been a lot of glimpses of attempts to try and play good rugby. There's been a lot of hard forward work involved in making a way forward, and it was obviously the discussion at half time that tidied up the effort